everybody. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. The new season is finally upon us, and for the Falcons, they have high expectations at the quarterback spot this season. It's the Buccaneers going up against the Falcons. With that, let's get over to Atlanta as we welcome in our brand new broadcast pairing for 2016. I think you'll like them. It's Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Okay, Larry, we certainly hope they do. We're looking forward to this year, and we begin it here in the final season opener at the Georgia Dome in Atlanta. Today, our new season begins with an NFC South matchup between the Tampa Bay Buccaneers and the Atlanta Falcons. And as we look at this matchup for the Bucs, they were 6-10 a season ago. The Falcons 8-8, but remember, they got off to that really hot start.
It was a tale of two seasons for them, really. The first half of the season and...
Freeman, the lone man in the backfield. Looking to throw. He's got the NFL's leading receiver a year ago, Julio Jones.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route, and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and give the quarterback a really nice target.
The NFC second leading rusher a year ago, Devontae Freeman. Only a gain of a yard there, but it indeed gets him a new set of downs.
Second and inches is oftentimes an invitation for an offense coordinator to take a big shot downfield because he feels like he can come back on third down and pick up the first down. But sometimes you just don't want to break tendency. Stay with what you are, stay with who you know, and go get the first down. That's exactly what they did.
They'll look to throw now on first down. And the catch is made by Justin Hardy. And he's brought down. They call it a gain of 19, and it moves the chains.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
This is Freeman on 1st and 10. And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of 2, and it'll be 2nd down.
The defense won that play so fast that I think if the running back even had time to notice if anyone was there, it was just a blink of an eye, and there was a loss on the play.
Again, they'll run with Freeman, and he'll get this down only to about the 46. Give him 2 yards that time, and it's going to leave him with a 3rd and 11 situation.
Well, I think we know by now that every run is not going to be broken and get all the way to the end zone, but these short ones still have their value. You can still set up your play action and throw the football. You control the clock because you have the ball and they don't, and often the physicality sets the tempo for the game.
Third down, he'll drop to throw. And that's caught by Tammy. They give him 14 yards that time and a fresh set of downs.
Well, the advantage certainly shifted to the defense as we began that 3rd down play, and they found a way to foil it and pick up a 1st down.
3rd time's a charm, right? 2 incompletions. Had to have it on 3rd, and they got it.
Yeah, they stuck with it, weren't daunted at all, and picked it up.
Back to throw now on 1st down. Being chased out left. Give him 3 on the play, and that'll make it 2nd down.
You know, I don't think this is the last time we'll see that in this game. This guy has mobility, and they want to use his legs in the game plan. So there will be designed runs as well as his scrambles.
So the offense now dealing with a second and 7. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. Forced out to his left. It goes as a gain of 8, and it moves the chains.
That was an excellent job of recognizing the situation. His first read wasn't there. Heck, his second read wasn't there. But he bought himself a little extra time scrambling out of the pocket, got to the sticks, and picked up the first down.
Fresh set of downs here. Looks like the defense in press coverage here.
Let's go! Blue 58!
They run. Devontae Freeman. They showed off a nice juke of the defender before the next wave could bring him down. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's 2nd and 4.
I know it's a word that we tend to overuse, but Devontae Freeman can be awfully explosive with the ball in his hands.
He showed at the beginning of last year. He had 10 touchdowns the first couple months. The Falcons themselves were red hot, then sort of went down the tubes a little bit toward the end.
Yeah, the team's record and its production declined the same way, but I really like his overall game.
Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. And he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Atlanta. Justin Hardy, a 15-yard touchdown grab. And the Falcons take it all the way down the field and score on the opening drive.
Okay, what a way to open a season. The first drive of the first game results in a touchdown. Could not have drawn it up any better.
Atlanta now coming out on the field. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
See if they stay on the ground for 2nd down. The former Indiana Hoosier here, Tevin Coleman. And he'll get it up here this time to the 21. So 1 quarter in the books on NFL kickoff weekend. 7-0 is our score. EA Sports NFL Sunday returns following this.
This presentation of the NFL on EA Sports is brought to you by Snickers. You're off your game when you're hungry. Snickers satisfies.
Alongside Charles Davis, Brandon Gordon, it's the Falcons in possession to begin quarter number 2, and they've got it here with a 1st down. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. Down, eluding the pressure right, and some room to run now, and he's brought down. Give him 13 on the pickup there, and it'll be 1st down Atlanta.
Man, defensively, that hurts. They got him out of his rhythm, they had him hemmed in, but somehow he was able to tuck it away and get away for a gain.
Down, he'll drop to throw it. Caught on the right side by Jones. A gain of 4 on the play, and that'll bring up 2nd down.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go, because he might wander into some tough coverage.
They'll set up the screen for Freeman. Oh, spinning away. And he'll get up to the 43-yard line. 6 yards on the pickup, and that's going to make it third down and less than a yard.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass. Looked like it was coming together. Looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid game.
Freeman, and he gets it down to the 48. Enough for the first. 9 yards on the pickup there, and it keeps the drive alive.
I always appreciate runners who understand situations. That was just third and inches. No reason to dance around in the backfield and try and break off a bigger play. Just go pick up the first down, and that's exactly what he did.
Freeman, the lone man in the backfield. He'll drop to throw. Escaping the pressure right. And he lost the football. And it's picked up by the Buccaneers. And they will set up shop at their own 41-yard line. He had gained really good yardage, but that's what you tell your quarterbacks, right? Get down after you've got the run.
You don't have to prove your toughness. You know, I think that's what a lot of coaches are trying to preach to their guys. Get the yardage, get down, protect the football, and protect yourself from it.
Atlanta now coming out on the field. Now, last drive, obviously not what you're looking for. You've got the lead. You got to protect the football.
So, in other words, someone got lucky because they've been moving the ball really well and wearing them down. In this case, though, giving up the football doesn't make them very happy. They can't wait to get back out there and atone for it.
Yeah, try to atone for it here on this drive.
I think they're ahead of schedule now after that run. They might be bold with this second down call after that type of a game.
Second down following the run. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. It's hauled in by Hardy. He's at the 50, the 30, past the 20. Touchdown, Falcons! Justin Hardy, an even 90 yards. And the Falcons are able to show off their quick strike ability. And I think it's safe to say we won't call many touchdown passes longer than that this year, Parker.
No, I would agree with that totally. And right now, you're looking at an offensive coordinator. Conservative would not go next to his name. Risk taker, definitely, because he valued the opportunity to create a big play against what could have been disaster if they end up...
Here comes the Atlanta offense now ready to take over here. And they will simply, Charles, be looking to duplicate what they did last drive when they were able to push it in for six.
And they hope it'll be that easy, right? To be able to take...
And he fires one that's intercepted. A great read and it's picked off. And his guys are going to take... Atlanta now coming out on the field. And we'll see how this is played. Offensively, they've got the lead. Not a whole lot of time left. What do you think, Charles?
Well, it's tempting to try and add to your lead, but a mistake there, that can change things in a big way. I say go ahead, take the knee, get on out for the half.
Give him 9 on the play, and it'll be second and about a yard. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo.
Now, that was not a bad scramble there on first down. He didn't force it, nor did he throw it away. He was able to take off, and now he made it a very manageable second and short.
It's a loss of 2, now third down. A pass for negative yardage, obviously no good. Maybe he shouldn't have thrown it, or maybe he shouldn't have caught it.
And I think we were seeing it at the same time, weren't we? Maybe you let that one go, right? Because you can see the lost yardage about to develop. But that goes against every instinct of a receiver. They're taught to catch everything. So it's really hard to be mad at him and yell at him for trying to make that play.
And that is caught. Touchdown, Falcons. Julio Jones, 64 yards. And the Falcons will extend their lead. And that'll give them a two-score lead here, but I'm looking ahead. They just want to hold it for the final moments here of the second quarter. They don't want to give up anything on the other side.
No, not at all, because if they don't, it almost had the feel of an imposing their will score.
So we get set to start this third quarter. Here's the Falcons offense now. They have the lead here. Well, we talk a lot about pregame speeches. What are halftime speeches like?
For the most part, not nearly as emotional. They're a lot more clinical. Every now and then, though, they'll get after you if they think they need to light a fire. But in this case, let's go into the virtual locker room, because here's what I think happened. They got in there and they said, listen, let's take control right away.
Yeah,
defense,
we got the lead.
Defense, don't give up any points.
And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. It's the Bucs' new signee from New York, Robert Ayers, in there to drop him with his first sack of 2016. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. Steps away to his left. Oh, he's got some breathing room. Touchdown, Falcons! Michael Vick, 56 yards. And the Falcons will add on to their lead. Boy, you want to talk about making something out of nothing. Boy, he did that right there. What an incredible run.
Obviously a pass play, and he couldn't find anyone open downfield. But sometimes the receivers just run those defenders off, and it creates a wide open space.
And here now come the Falcons. And that recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown looked pretty good, so they'll be hoping to do that once more.
And it takes me back to when we sat with the offensive coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan and thought there were some holes in the defense, and they exploited.
And I think he's going to go. They're not going to get him. Touchdown, Falcons. Justin Hardy with now 3 week 1 touchdowns. And the Falcons will extend their lead.
And this is obviously quite a performance. And most of the time when we talk about someone putting a team on their back, I think we're talking about a guy who runs the football. In this case, it's a guy out wide catching it, and he's done exactly that, truly leading his team right now towards victory.
3 touchdown catches. He's been the head. Atlanta now coming out on the field. And last time, the formula was pretty simple. One play drive, long pass. That, maybe they just want to do that again, right?
And that's exactly how you want to draw things up, whether it's on your...
Now the ball comes loose. And his guys are going to get the football at the 28-yard line. Often on fumbles, you look at the guy who coughed it up and say, geez, what did he do? But, hey, let's tip the cap to the defense here.
Not a problem at all, my man. I'm not even going to tip it. I'm going to doff my cap to him. Congratulations. Big-time play. Knocking it free and creating something good for your team.
Now the Buccaneers offensive unit back out on the field. Freeman, the lone man in the backfield. They'll try and start this drive in the air. Dancing to his left. And he'll just chuck this one up into row G. It's incomplete.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. The Pro Bowl wideout Julio Jones is intended receiver. And it'll be 3rd and 10.
The goal of anyone running a curl route is to make sure you try and get defenders on your back and shield them away from the football. But sometimes, even when you run a good route, the defense finds a way to knock it away.
Looking to throw. Buying time to his left. He may try and it's a fumble. But this will fortunately wind up out of bounds.
Now I have to admit, Parker, that I've often thought that I don't like this rule, where the offensive player fumbles the ball, it goes out of bounds, and they get to keep it.
That's just because you're a defensive guy. That's why you don't like it.
Yeah, you're right. It is a slanted view, isn't it?
But this is where, for the offensive team, the sideline is their friend. Usually it's not their friend.
Yeah, exactly right. I actually played for a guy in college. You know what he used to name the sideline? Sammy. Sammy sideline, and use him well. I like his thought process and his ability to move and get downfield. But what I didn't like was the final decision, to go out of bounds. They want to keep the clock moving. Instead, they give the defense an extra timeout.
They'll look to throw. And oh, not only did he drop it, he dropped it in the end zone.
After all the preparation, all the practice, a play like that will absolutely break your heart. They had everything they wanted, just unable to complete it. In the end zone, a big-time drop.
They'll drop to throw. Flush to his right. And he dropped it. Now it was tipped. Altered the ball a little bit, but he dropped. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. Now a play fake here on first down. Steps away. And finding the tight end, Hooper. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. 7 yards on the play, and it'll be a second down. And now they're in the hurry up. Back to throw here. Being chased out left. Oh, he got position on him, and he pulls it in. And he's brought down after a good game. Coleman now, spinning past him. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. Well, at least he was able to break that initial contact, or it could have been a loss.
Yeah, give credit to the defensive player, though. What did he do? Made him slow down, slow up his feet, and allowed the rest of the guys to get there to finish him off.
Back to throw now on second and 10. And this is going to be caught. He won the fight for the football. A really nice gain of 25 yards. He's played a great game. It continues right there, even with this lead. Confident to throw the pass and have the reception made.
There's no doubt who the leader of their team is there? There's no doubt who they want to ride all the way to the finish. The strategy would tell you.
And he is into the end zone for a Falcon touchdown. Justin Hardy with a career-high 4-touchdown game. And the Falcons will add on to their lead. And let's count them up now. 1, 2, 3, 4 touchdown receptions for him in this game.
And just one shy of the NFL record. What a great performance.
Like he'll throw here. He's going to sling this deep downfield. And the defense loses him. It's complete. And he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly.
In order to lead in a game, you're going to get plenty of contributors. But that's his second touchdown catch of this game. He's one of the key guys in this one.
And you better believe he'll be looking for the hat trick here as this one continues to go. Brought down inside the 20 at the 19. It'll be a 2-yard gain, and it's a second down.
Yeah, he only gets a few yards on first and 10, but he's better off doing that than throwing an incompletion or even worse, an interception.
They're going to hurry back to the line now. He'll drop to throw. They'll set up the screen for Freeman. And Freeman lost the football. Second down fumble. Now the offense needing to do something here on third down. the gun. They'll look to throw. Oh, it's a touchdown if he holds on. Instead, it's fourth down. So that'll just about do it for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, log on to easports.com. It's a win for the Falcons here as we say so long from Atlanta.